Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making peanut butter pudding, and that is a dessert that I thought maybe some of you hadn't tried. And I always look for things that are a little unusual because I've gotten all of my normal things that are just standard desserts or standard meals, like mashed potatoes and green beans and fried chicken and all of that kind of stuff. So here we go with peanut butter pudding. And it starts with a medium-sized pot that you're going to take to the stove, and you will add to that sugar. We have 1/2 cup of granulated sugar, so just put that in the pot. And then we have cornstarch. There are 2 tablespoons measured out here. So 2 tablespoons of cornstarch will go into the mix. And then we have salt. I use iodized salt. You can use any kind of salt. This is 1/4 teaspoon. Of salt. So those are our dry ingredients that we're going to mix together. And it just takes a slight toss here to get those together. And that's good enough on that. Now, what I'm going to do is come down here and get some milk. I'm using skim milk. You can use any type of milk that you normally would use. I've got 1 1/2 cups. Measured out, and I'm just going to put that in here, and then I'm going to add some 1/2 and 1/2, so that makes it a little creamier. This is 1/2 cup of 1/2 and 1/2. Put that in the mix. Now I'm going to pick up my whisk, which I set out, and I'm going to whisk these a little bit before going to the stove. I just want to get them all together, and then here's what I plan to do. I'm going to go over to the stove and turn it to medium heat, and I'm going to bring this to a boil. But while I'm bringing it to a boil, I'm going to be whisking the whole time. Once it comes to a boil, we'll boil it for 1 minute, whisking constantly. And then I'll come back and show you where we are at that point. So let's get started by turning on the stove to medium. Here we go, and then here we're whisking. This is what your pudding looks like as it is lightly bubbling over here, and I have been whisking it continuously since I came over, and it's had about 1 minute of boiling. So let's take it back to our workspace and turn this off. And we've got a couple of things to add to make it actually peanut butter pudding. See how smooth this is? Now it will be very thin, because it will thicken up later, but it has to be smooth for it to be a good pudding. We're going to be adding our peanut butter, so you need creamy peanut butter, any brand, or if you want a reduced fat kind or reduced sugar, whatever, but you need 3/4 cup. So we've got that right here. Just putting that in, a little bit to scrape off the bottom there. And then also vanilla, vanilla extract, 1 teaspoon. Goes in. Now what I'm going to do is start whisking this, and you'll see that the peanut butter melts pretty easily into the other mixture. If you find it difficult to whisk, then you may use a mixer, but you've got to get this blended together completely in order to have your peanut butter pudding. It's coming together all right with a whisk, but just give me a minute and I'll get it together and we'll serve it up into a nice bowl. This is what your peanut butter pudding will look like if you keep whisking, and I didn't need the electric mixer. This was just fine because it was so hot that it melted the peanut butter, and that made it really easy to manipulate. So now we're going to choose some kind of serving bowl, such as this one, and we'll pour this in. And you see it's extremely hot right now because it actually just came off the stove and got those additional ingredients added. So it will have to be cooled. Let me get all this out. It's kind of hard with this particular utensil, but I always like to leave a little for Rick to lick in case he wants it. It's done, actually. Now what I'm going to do is put some plastic wrap over the top, and I'm going to show you how to do that in just a second, but first I'm going to take a little taste of it. It's really good when it's warm, and now this is really hot, but you can see, I think when I dip down into it, you can see how velvety it is. It's really a lovely texture, so I don't mean to take that much, but just a little bite. This is wonderful if you like peanut butter. And you can leave it like this for 2 hours in your refrigerator. And when you put this plastic wrap on, what you need to do is go down to the surface and let it stick on the surface. It's not going to melt the plastic wrap, don't worry about that. But it does give a tight seal. Otherwise, even when you put plastic wrap on, it will have a tendency to form a skin over the top, and it's not very attractive that way. This way, you just pull off the plastic wrap and it's going to look neat. So it's ready to serve after it chills for 2 hours. I hope you enjoy this recipe. Here's our peanut butter pudding that I got out of the refrigerator. You can see that it's set up, and this plastic wrap that I put on it is easy to peel away from the bottom. Actually, I should have made it adhere to all parts and there wouldn't be those little valleys in there, but it doesn't matter because we're just going to spoon it out into a serving dish anyway. Now it's ready to go, so we can spoon it out and serve it, or you can garnish it if you want to. And I decided to do this for a garnish. I got some whipping cream, and actually this is 36% heavy whipping cream, so it's not as fatty as just getting whipping cream. And I've already whipped it up until it has soft peaks. I'm going to add some sugar. You don't have to do that. If you're fine with just using whipping cream that has been whipped, that will be nice for part of your garnish. But I think most people like it sweetened, so I'm using confectioner sugar. This is 1/3 of a cup. I'm just going to sprinkle a little in there and then make a decision later as to whether I want to put more. So probably half of that. We'll see how it looks. So I'm going to be using a mixer, and we'll let it come to stiff peaks, and then we'll stop there because we don't want butter. Now I only used about half of that 1/3 cup of powdered sugar that I had out. I asked Rick to take a taste of it and see if he liked it the way it was, and he did. We don't like to put extra sugar in if we don't need it, so just use your own judgment. No sugar at all, or the 1/3 cup. I don't think it needs any more than 1/3 cup. Okay, here's what we're going to do to serve it. We're going to take a serving bowl, just something about the right size for pudding, and then we'll dip into this and get some peanut butter pudding. You can see that it's going to take whatever shape you dip out. And we'll give a nice generous serving here. And that looks good. Now to top it, we're going to put a spoon of this sweetened whipped cream, or just whipped cream if you chose to do that. It looks nice on it. And you can stop there. What I've decided is that peanut butter and bananas go really well together. And so since this is peanut butter pudding, why don't we use banana chips for the top? Well, we don't want to have the big banana chips because that would be a whole spoonful in itself. So what I did was to put this in a kitchen chopper, and you'll see what it looks like. It makes a neat little topping here that you can put on top of your whipped cream and let it go down the sides a little bit into the peanut butter pudding. So that's what we have to serve to our guests. Or just take a spoon and start eating it yourself. I think you'll like it.